Welcome friends, this is Sid and I welcome you all to this session. In today's session, we will solve a tie condition problem in a simplex method. This problem is also called as a degenerate problem. Okay, so let us look at the objective function, constraint equations and non-equality constraint. So first, I will write the objective function, which is z equal to 5qa plus 3qb. Now I will write the constraints equation. The first equation is 4qa plus 9qb less than equal to 20. The second equation is 2qa plus 7qb less than equal to 10. So now in the simplex method, what we do, we remove the inequality constraints using a slack or surplus variable. As we have a less than condition here, we will add a slack variable. So let me write this equation, 4qa plus 9qb plus s1 equal to 20. The second equation, 2qa plus 7qb plus 0s1 plus s2 equal to 10. So here I can write 0 multiplied by s2. So now you can see we have added two slack variables as we have two equations. Now I can rewrite the objective function as z equal to 5qa plus 3qb plus 0s1 plus 0s2. Okay, now if you have gone through the last lecture where we have solved our first problem, I hope you would have known that how we can start solving this problem. And if you haven't gone through this, I request you to please go through it. Okay, qa, qb, s1, s2, right hand side, theta, okay, and here I will write cj, here I will write s1, s2. The cj is nothing but the z, and here we will write the coefficient of qa in the objective function, which is 5. Here I will write, so here we will get 3, here we will get 0 and 0. So this s1 is nothing but this equation, which is 1. So here the coefficient of qa in equation 1 is 4, the coefficient of qb is 9, the coefficient of s1 is 1, coefficient of s2 is 0, the right hand side is 20. Similarly, if this is equation 2, I will get 2 here, 7 here, 0 here, 1 here and 10 here. Okay. So now let me calculate zj, which is nothing but summation of si by qi. Okay, so here the coefficient of s1 is 0, so I will write 0 here, the coefficient of s2 is 0, so 0 multiplied by 4 plus 0 multiplied by 2 is 0, here 0 multiplied by 9 is 0 plus 0 multiplied by 7 is 0, so total is 0. Similarly, I will get 0 here and 0 here. So initially we will get 0 in this particular row. Now we will calculate cj minus zj. So cj is 5, 5 minus 0 is 5, 3 minus 0 is 3, 0 minus 0 is 0, 0 minus 0 is 0. Now after calculating cj minus zj, we will check these values and we will find the maximum value. So the maximum value in this equation is 5. That means this variable will go into the problem. Okay, that means qa will enter into the problem. That means this is our pivot column. So if QA will enter into the problem, either S1 or S2 will go out from the problem. So to calculate that, what we do, we use to calculate this theta, which is nothing but the right hand side divided by the element of the pivot column. So for S1 it is 4, so 20 by 4 is 5 and 10 by 2 is 5. If we have gone through the last lecture, what we had done, we had find a minimum value and we had taken that variable out from the problem. But in this condition, we have obtained the same value. Okay, so this type of problem is known as a degenerate problem. So now to solve this problem, what we will do, we will find out the select variable divided by the pivot element. So the value of select variable is 1. So let me first remove this. So S1 by 4, which is 1 by 4, this is 0.25, and here S2 by 2, which is 1 by 2, which is 0.5. So we will consider the minimum value. That means S1 will go out from the problem. Okay, this, that means this is our pivot row. So this makes 4 the pivot element. Now S1 will be replaced by QA. So I will write QA here, and that will be S1 divided by the pivot element. So this will be 4 by 4, 1, 9 by 4, this will be 1 by 4, this will be 0, and this will be 5. Now this is S2. If you have gone through the last lecture, what we had done, we had make an identity matrix between the variable which is entering into the problem and the select variable which is left into the problem, which is S2. So we will have to make identity matrix between QA and S2. So we already have the QA. Now we have to make, now to make identity matrix, we will have to make 0 here and 1 here. So we already have 1 in the S2. So let me just give this equation 1, this is 2, this is 3, and this is 4. I have just written this row just for the convenience. You do not have to write this in the, you do not have to write this in your answer. Okay, so what I will do, I will put this R2, multiply equation 3 by 2. So if I multiply this by 2 and minus it from here, I will get 0 here. Okay, so 2 minus 2 is 0, 7 minus 9 by 2 will be 5 by 4, this will be minus 1 by 2, okay, this will be 1, and this will be 0, 10 minus 10. Okay, now I will calculate ZJ. So the coefficient of QA is 5, the coefficient of S2 is 0. So 5 multiplied by 1 plus 0 multiplied by 0, so this will be 5. 5 multiplied by 9 by 4, this will be 45 by 4, this will be 5 by 4, this will be 0. Okay, now I will calculate CJ minus ZJ. So 5 minus 5 is 0, 3 minus 45 by 4, so this will be minus 33 by 4, this will be minus 5 by 4, and this will be 0. Now you can see QA and QB both are either equal to 0 or less than 0. That means we have obtained our optimal solution here. That means QA is equal to 5 and we obtain QB equal to 0. So this is our optimal solution, 5, 0. Okay, so in order to check whether we have done the right solution or not, let me just solve this problem using the graphical method. Okay, so I will copy this objective function and constraint equation and I will paste them here. Okay, now I will solve this problem using graphical method. So let me first draw the x and y axis. So now let me first solve this equation, okay, taking it as 1. So in this equation, considering QA in this direction and QB in this direction, so if I put QB equal to 0 in this equation, I will get QA as 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is our point where I will get 5, 0. If in this equation I put QA equal to 0, I will get QB as 20/9, which will be around something 2.2. So this point will be somewhere here. So here I will get 0, 20/9. So let me draw a straight line along these two points. This is equation 4QA plus 9QB less than equal to 20. As the condition is less than, that means we will go in the downward direction. Now if I solve the equation 2, so in this equation if I put QB equal to 0, I will get QA as 5. So this point will be same, 5, 0. Now in this equation if I put QA equal to 0, I will get QB as 10/7, which will be around something 1.4. So this will be corner somewhere here. So 0, 10/7. So let me draw a straight line along these two points. So this equation is 2QA plus 7QB less than equal to 10. As the condition is less than, we will go in the downward direction. And now if I put the non-equality constraints, which are QA is greater than or equal to 0 and QB is greater than or equal to 0. So this will be this line, which have QB equal to 0, QA equal to 0. Okay. So this will be our common area, or you can say the optimal area where we will get the maximum output. Okay, so in this we have obtained three extreme points. The first point is 0, 0, the second point is this, the third point is this. So let me calculate the objective function as z1, so this will be 0, and z2, which is 0, 10/7. If I put here in this equation, I will get 0 and 30/7. Now let me calculate for third point, 5, 0. So this will be 25, this will be 0, so I will get 25. Now you can see out of these three we are obtaining the maximum value at this point. So from here we have obtained QA equal to 5 and QB equal to 0. So you can check these two values are same. Okay, so we have obtained the same solution using a graphical method and a simplex method. Okay. Now I request you to please go through this problem again and solve it by yourself, so you will get the real understanding. Okay. And please subscribe our channel for more upcoming videos like this. Thank you very much. Have a good day.